Good evening. I'm Lloyd Newell, announcer for the Mormon Tabernacle Choir's weekly broadcast of Music and the Spoken Word. And on behalf of the First Presidency of the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints, we welcome you to the annual Pioneer Day concert by the Mormon Tabernacle Choir and Orchestra at Temple Square. Tonight's concert features our guest artist, award-winning actress and star of Broadway's Cinderella, Laura Osnes. We are thrilled to have her with us this evening. We wish to acknowledge the presence of President Thomas S. Monson, President of the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints, who is with us this evening. Thank you, President Monson. We welcome general authorities of the church and other community, civic, and government leaders who are also joining us this evening. In keeping with our tradition here on Temple Square, we would like to begin this evening with a word of prayer to be offered by Melissa Pope, a member of the choir.
Our Father in heaven, we are so grateful to be gathered here in this beautiful setting to celebrate the spirit of the pioneers and the joy and beauty of music. We thank thee for the pioneers' legacy and for the opportunity that we have to celebrate and rejoice in the beauty and the inspiration of great lives lived with courage and faith and vision. We thank thee for pioneers in every age, for those who have sacrificed much and prepared the way to provide better and brighter lives and brighter futures, in order that we might be able to enjoy great freedoms and that we might have the opportunity to live lives of peace and happiness. We pray for the Holy Spirit to be here this evening. We pray for all those who will perform and those who will listen, that together we might be uplifted, that the love of the Lord Jesus Christ and the faith and joy of the pioneer spirit might shine through the music and into our hearts. And this prayer we offer in the name of our Savior Jesus Christ. Amen.
Was
Through song, we remember the trials and travails faced by the Mormon pioneers who crossed the plains to settle what must have appeared to be a most inhospitable valley. We also remember the hope and conviction that carried them along over so many months and miles. It was their prophetic leader, Brigham Young, who with unflagging optimism declared that it was his faith that, quote, has done everything for me. It has made me happy. It has filled me with good feelings, with joy and rejoicing. In that same spirit, the Mormon Tabernacle Choir, Orchestra at Temple Square, and Broadway sensation Laura Osnes combine their talents to bring you this evening of joy and rejoicing.
Star Laura Osnes.
Forget your troubles, come on, get happy. You better chase all your cares away. Shout hallelujah, come on, get happy. Get ready for the judgment day. The sun's shining, come on, get happy. The Lord is waiting to take your hand. Shout hallelujah, come on, get happy. We're going to the promised land. We're heading across the river. Wash your sins away in time. It's all so peaceful on the other side. Forget your troubles, come on, get happy. You better chase all your cares away. Shout hallelujah, come on, get happy. Get ready for the judgment day. Forget your troubles, come on, get happy. Chase your cares away. Hallelujah. hallelujah, get happy before the judgment day. The sun is shining, come on, get happy. The Lord is waiting to take your hand. Shout hallelujah, come on, get happy. We're gonna be going to the promised land. We're heading across the river. Wash your sins away in the tide. It's quiet and peaceful on the other side. Forget your troubles, get happy, your cares fly away. Shout hallelujah, get happy, get ready for your judgment day. Come on, get happy, chase your cares away. Shout hallelujah, come on, get happy, get ready for the judgment day. Sun shining, come on, get happy, the Lord is waiting to take your hand. Hallelujah, come on, get happy, we're going to the promised land. We're heading across the river, wash your sins away in the tide. It's all so peaceful on the other side. Forget your troubles, come on, get happy, chase your cares away. Shout hallelujah, come on, get happy, get ready, get ready, get ready for the judgment day.
Just thrilled to be here with all of you and with this magnificent choir and orchestra. Thank you so much to Mack, Wilberg, and Ryan Murphy for having me tonight. Now, I want to let you in on a little known fact. This isn't my first time performing in front of a largely, you know, Mormon audience. In fact, I once sang at the Manhattan 8th Ward Chapel in New York City, but it wasn't quite this size. So as excited as I am that you all came tonight, I have to admit, it's a little bit overwhelming. But one other little tidbit. Some of you may remember that a year ago, my dear friend and onstage Prince Charming, Santino Fontana, was here for this concert. Remember him? Well, after I saw the size of the hall, I called him last night for a little pep talk, and he said to say hi to all of you. So hello from Santino. Of course, I love Santino, and sharing a Broadway stage with him in Cinderella was way beyond a dream come true for this Midwestern girl. But I want to clarify that Santino was only my true love on stage. And tonight, my real-life Prince Charming and husband, Nate, is here tonight. Nate, do you want to stand up and say hello to all these nice people? My heart. Nate and I just celebrated our 8th wedding anniversary. And babe, thank you. And this next song, All the Things You Are, is for you.
Trembles on the
George M. Cohan, often called the father of Broadway, was quite literally born into show business. In fact, he began his career before he could walk or talk as an onstage prop in his family's traveling vaudeville show. Small wonder then that by age 26, his first play premiered on Broadway, followed by almost 40 more that he wrote, composed, produced, and often appeared in. Tonight, we honor the remarkable and unforgettable contributions of this American icon with a unique salute to the man who owned Broadway.
I'm gonna give us all the candy, I'm gonna make it to the candy, I'm glad I am, so's Uncle Sam. I'm a real like Yankee Doodle, make my favorite favorite noodle, just like Mr. Doodle did by riding on a pole.
Anything about a Yankee that's a boy. I'm a Yankee too. There's a thing that comes a stealing, and it sets my brain a feeling when I listen to the music of a military band. Any tune I think he doodle simply sets me off my noodle. It's a patriotic something that no one can understand. Hurrah for the flag of the free!
It's so inspiring.
So inspiring.
Come on and join the
jubilee. Red, white, and blue, I am for you. On this your grand old flag.
You're the half-hearted flag, and forever in peace may you wear.
It could be said that both individually and together, Richard Rodgers and Oscar Hammerstein have done more for musical theater than anyone who came before or after. When Oklahoma opened in 1943, they began a collaboration that gave the world musicals that likely will never be forgotten, including State Fair, The King and I, South Pacific, The Sound of Music, and of course, Cinderella. Please join with us in remembering two extraordinary men who gave the world the golden age of Broadway.
If you love musical theater, you most likely love Rodgers and Hammerstein. I know I totally do, and I've been fortunate enough to play five of their heroines. So, what's not to love? One of those opportunities was this past spring in Chicago, where I was privileged to play Julie Jordan in the lyric opera production of Carousel. And in it, I got to sing one of Rodgers and Hammerstein's most lyric and beautiful songs, If I Loved You. Thank you. I worked in the mill, weaving at the loom. I'd gaze absent-minded at the roof. And half the time the shuttle would tangle in the threads, and the warp would get mixed with the woof. If I loved you. Exactly how I'd be if I loved you time and again. I would try to say all I'd want you. don't quite know where it came from, but ever since I was 5 years old, I've wanted to perform on Broadway. And my training began in my parents' living room, belting out show tunes with my Fisher-Price tape recorder. I don't know, do you think we're born with those types of gifts and dreams? Well, whatever it may be, those early daydreams have taken me from playing a random munchkin in my second grade production of The Wizard of Oz, to making my Broadway debut as Sandy in Grease, to transforming into a princess on stage night after night. And now, this. Another dream come true. Thank you so much for this absolutely magical opportunity. This has truly been a lovely night. A lovely night, a lovely night, a finer night you know you'll never see. You meet your prince, a charming prince, as charming as a prince will ever be. The stars in a hazy heaven tremble above you while he is whispering, "Darling, I love you." You say goodbye, away you fly, but on your lips you keep a kiss. All your life you'll dream of this lovely, lovely night. A lovely night, a lovely night, a finer night you know you'll never see. You meet your prince, a charming prince, as charming as a prince will ever be. The stars in a hazy heaven tremble above you while he is whispering, "Darling, I love you." You say goodbye, away you fly, but on your lips you keep a kiss. All your life you'll dream of this lovely, lovely night. The stars in a hazy heaven tremble above you while he is whispering, "Darling, I love you." You say goodbye, away you fly, but on your lips you keep a kiss. All your life you'll dream of this lovely, lovely.
We belong to his grand. and mommy of them, and only a handful of us, and how could a toil of them, by the mighty machine?
And maybe a legion of them, and only a parcel of us, but it isn't the size of the fist, it's the size of the dream.